So, we meet again. Hey everybody. We'll get started in 5 minutes at the usual time at 2 o'clock East Coast time. Thanks for coming to all of you. And I'll just say hi to a few people coming in the room, like Maddie, Julie, Josh, and Abby, for starters. Say hi to you guys. And who else is here? Gonna have some fun today. William's here. Hi, William. And Tyler, Darcy, Gianluca, and Matteo. Seen those names before. Nice to see you back. I love it when people come back. I love it when you bring new people too. If you have friends who might get a kick out of this, call them up on the phone. You know, get them over here. So there's also Claire and Connor in Tennessee. Logan's here, and Casey and McKenna in Illinois. Kaylee, Kevin and Ashwin, Kark, Charles, Mom are here, Jacob and Amelia, Ian and Erica from Virginia, Carter, Ethan and Hayden, CJ, David, Philip, the crazy coppers are here. Coppers? Isn't that supposed to be Coopers? Anyway. John in California, Nora and Eloise, Evan, David, Lucy, Lainey, Sydney, Shane, Philip, Philip, oh, another Philip, sorry. And they start scrolling by really fast. Skyla, the Brooks brothers, and Ryan, and Daniel, Josephine, I think that was. It went by so fast. Kaylee, David, Hattie, Ashlyn in Myrtle Beach, South Carolina, William in Hawley, Pennsylvania, Josephine is here, and Zachary, Shannon. Hi to all of you. We're going to get started in 3 minutes at 2 o'clock East Coast time. Reed, Darcy, Abby, Isabel, William, Jonelle, Indianapolis is here, Molly and Stella, Charlie, Petey, Henry. Somebody's in a car. Natalia, Oliver, Colin, Cora, Peter, Brandon, Cookie and Cream are here. Both of them. Ginny, Beth, and Daniel, Kaylee and Blaine, Joshua, Sophia, Lainey, Ben. We got 170 people already. Darcy, Ethan, Emma, and Joelle, and Bella, Jack, and Ella, Avery, Ethan, Shane, Corinne Foley, hi to all of you. We got 2 minutes to go before we get started. Ethan's here. Billy Sickles is here. Corinne, oh, I said Corinne already. Andrew, Ryan, Lucas, and Owen in Minnesota. Tyler's here. And Ethan, Laney, Ben, Mattingly, Brady, Violet, and Stephson. I think you spelled that wrong. The Sprunk Boys in Morrisville, Pennsylvania. Max and Layla, the Foley Boys. Ryan, Meredith, Mason, Josh, Corinne, Smith Kids from Texas. Tatiana in New Jersey. Shane's here. We got 2 minutes to go. Still time to get your friends over. The Kendricks here are here. Abigail and Chester. Emmett and Oliver in Buffalo. Emma. Okay. Alexandra and Hannah, I'm psyched. You guys psyched? Let's go. Let's do this thing. Friday. Got a big weekend coming up, right? Bet some of you are finished with school now. No more school. Either online or in person, at all. You got this whole summer to yourselves. Mia, Elise in Vegas. Connor, Kaylee, and JD. Mia, I think I said Mia already. Could be another Mia. Who knows? Any second. The Markwood crew. Maddie. It's go time, baby. Hi, Dan Gutman here. I am the guy who writes the My Weird School series and lots of other books for kids too. And it's Friday, and you know what that means? It means we finish our book today that we've been reading all week. Great. But first, before we do that, how about our question of the day, which comes from Eli. I don't know where Eli's from, but Eli knows. Eli asks, what becomes of AJ and his friends when they grow up? I know they stay in third grade in the books, but if they could grow up, what would they become? Interesting question. Honestly, Eli, I'd never give any thought to what happens to these fictional characters after the books are over. But if you're going to force me to speculate, I will say that Andrea, I'm sure, is going to grow up and become like a doctor or a lawyer, okay? Emily will become Andrea's assistant, you know? Let's see. Alexia, I could see her starting a skateboarding camp, you know, or a school. Ryan will probably become a chef or something involving food. I don't know about Michael and Neil, but I will say that AJ, I would guess, if I had to guess, I'd say he's going to become like a car salesman. He work for an automobile dealership. That's just my guess, okay? All right, so let's get started with our book of the week. Mr. Nick is a lunatic. We're going to finish it today. And as you know, if you've been watching, the teachers went on strike because the coffee machine in the teacher's lounge broke. And Dr. Carbles, the mean president of the Board of Education, refused to replace it. So the teachers went on strike. They went on a picket line in front of the school. Dr. Carbles showed up in a tank and drove them away with water hoses and dogs. He's really mean. And he replaced them with Mr. Nick, who is the new principal. His girlfriend, Moonbeam Starlight, who becomes the teacher. Then Mr. Bob is the art teacher now, and he's Mr. Nick's dentist. Miss Julia is the new lunch lady, and she's Mr. Nick's personal chef. And Mrs. Hall is the creative writing teacher now, and she is Mr. Nick's yoga instructor, okay? All of them were horrible teachers. They were terrible. And the kids got very upset. They made their own protest signs, and they decided that they were gonna protest in front of the school. And the last chapter ended with a tank rolling up to the school. Okay, that's where we are now. We're gonna read chapter 9 and 10 today, and chapter 9 is titled, Release the Dogs. You guys ready? Gather around, your big screen TV, your laptop, your tablet, whatever it is. Let's get started. The tank stopped in the middle of the street, right in front of us. The hatch on the top opened, and I think you can guess whose head popped out. It was Dr. Carbles, the president of the Board of Education, of course.
What are you kids doing out of school? He asked.
We want our teachers back, we chanted. We want our teachers back.
Put down those silly signs and return to class,
Dr. Carbles shouted through a bullhorn.
I have called in the police and the fire department.
Okay, here's a picture of, Jim's picture of Dr. Carbles threatening the kids from his tank. Okay? All right. Will you bring back our old teachers? Asked Andrea.
No,
shouted Dr. Carbles.
Go back to school.
We want our teachers, not some weird creatures, somebody shouted. We want our teachers, not some weird creatures, we all started chanting.
If you kids don't return to school right now,
shouted Dr. Carbles,
I will be forced to turn on the hoses and release the dogs.
Dogs, I said. I love dogs. I do love dogs. And getting sprayed by hoses is fun. One time I was washing my dog Buttons with a hose, and all the neighbors came over with their dogs, and we had a big neighborhood dog washing party. Everybody was spraying each other with water. That was cool.
Dr. Carbles has attacked dogs, dumbhead, said Andrea. He's going to attack us with dogs and hoses.
Your face looks like an attack dog, I told Andrea, because I couldn't think of anything else to say. Oh, snap, said Ryan. He's bluffing, said Michael. Dr. Carbles would never attack a bunch of kids with dogs.
Oh, you don't think so?
Shouted Dr. Carbles. The tank started to inch forward. We all took a step backward. That's when the most amazing thing in the history of the world happened. Andrea went over and stood in front of the tank. She put her hand in the air. Here's Andrea confronting the tank. Whoops. The tank stopped moving.
Move out of the way, young lady,
shouted Dr. Carbles.
I am warning you, I will crush your rebellion, just like I crushed your teacher's rebellion.
No, Andrea shouted back. I'm not moving until our teachers are allowed to come back to school.
Andrea is so brave, Emily said. When I grow up, I want to be just like Andrea. At that moment, sirens started blaring down the street. A bunch of police cars and fire trucks pulled up and screeched to a halt.
I'll give you one last chance, Andrea,
shouted Dr. Carbles.
Go back to school right now, or else.
Not until our teachers come back,
Andrea shouted.
Okay, you asked for it,
shouted Dr. Carbles.
Turn on the water hoses, men. Release the dogs.
All right, that's chapter 9. All right, you guys ready for chapter 10? The last chapter in the book, which is titled, of course, Big Surprise Ending. Here we go. I have to tell you, there was electricity in the air. Well, not really. If there was electricity in the air, we would have all been electrocuted. Before Dr. Carbles and his men had the chance to attack us, the weirdest thing in the history of the world happened. A delivery man came walking up the street. Well, that's not the weird part, because delivery men come walking up the street every day. The weird part was what happened next. Howdy do, everybody, the delivery man said. What's all the ruckus about? I have a package here for elementary school.
Put that box down, shouted Mr. Nick as he came running out of the school. There might be a bomb in there.
And here's a picture of the delivery man carrying the package to the school. And Mr. Nick is upset because he thinks it might be a bomb.
A bomb, a bomb, a bomb.
In case you were wondering, everybody was saying a bomb. The delivery man put the box down on the sidewalk very gently. A policeman got out of his car with one of the dogs. The dog started sniffing around the box.
She's trained to sniff out bombs, said the policeman.
Maybe there's some food in that box, Ryan whispered to me. I'm starving.
The dog stopped sniffing. I guess there wasn't a bomb in the box. Mr. Nick went over to the box and got down on his hands and knees. He slowly tore off a piece of tape on the top of the box. And here's a picture of Mr. Nick opening the box, and the dog is still there, the police dog. He's sweating. Okay.
Stand clear, he said. There could be anything in this package. It was so exciting. There was electricity in the air.
Well, not really. I thought we went over that already.
But we were on pins and needles.
Well, not really. We were just standing there. If we were on pins and needles, it would have hurt. But we were all glued to our seats. Well, not exactly. That would be weird. And there are no chairs outside. Why would anybody glue themselves to a seat anyway? How would you get the glue off? Mr. Nick opened the flaps on the box. He reached inside. He pulled something out. It was big. We all moved closer
to get a better look.
It's a coffee machine, Mr. Nick said.
Who ordered that?
Shouted Dr. Carbles angrily.
I didn't buy a coffee machine.
No, but we did. We all turned around. And you'll never believe in a million hundred years who was standing there. I'm not going to tell you. Okay, I'll tell you. It was Mr. Klutz and Mrs. Rupee and Ms. Hannah and all our regular teachers. Yay, we all yelled. You came back. And here's a picture of all the teachers showing up.
Klutz,
shouted Dr. Carbles.
I should have known it was you. Where have you been all day?
We were at Starbucks, said Mr. Klutz. We decided to chip in and buy our own coffee machine. Now we're ready to get back to work, doing what we love, teaching the youth of America.
Yay, we all yelled again.
You can't come back to work, Klutz,
shouted Dr. Carbles.
You're fired. Nick, please escort these students back into the school.
Everybody looked at Mr. Nick. Nah, I don't think so, man, said Mr. Nick. We know when we're not wanted. These kids don't appreciate us. This place is a bummer anyway.
Where do you think you're going?
Asked Dr. Carbles. Let's go to Starbucks, replied Mr. Nick as he got back on the bus. And here's Mr. Nick and his girlfriend getting back on the bus to leave.
You can't leave,
shouted Dr. Carbles.
I hired you for the whole week. You're under contract.
We're splitting, dude, said Mr. Nick. This school gives off bad vibes. Come on, Moon. Let's go get some coffee. Then we'll go back to the yurt. Mr. Nick's girlfriend, dentist, yoga instructor, and cook got on the bus.
Wait, stop. Come back here this minute,
shouted Dr. Carbles.
That's an order.
Hey, man, I don't take orders from the man, said Mr. Nick. I think for myself. And then he flashed a peace sign at Dr. Carbles as the bus pulled away. Well, I think it was a peace sign. Anyway, I didn't get a good look at it. Like I said before, I was hungry.
Who's going to run the school now?
Asked Andrea. Yeah, said Emily. Who's going to teach us?
Klutz,
shouted Dr. Carbles.
You're hired again.
Hooray, we all yelled. Everybody gathered around Mr. Klutz and our teachers, and we had a big group hug. And here's Jim's pictures of all the teachers and kids hugging each other because they're back to school. Strike is over. We missed you. We missed you too. And we all went back into the school. Well, that's pretty much what happened. Maybe our teachers will be normal again now that they have a coffee machine. Maybe Mr. Cooper will stop tripping over umbrellas. Maybe Mr. Nick will open up a vegetarian bookstore. Maybe Miss Moon will stop playing that horrible love song on her guitar. Maybe Mr. Bob will go back to being a dentist. Maybe Miss Julia will cook something for lunch besides water soup. Maybe we'll have a big dog washing party. Maybe some porpoises will show up in the old porpoise room. Maybe Dr. Carbles will go back to Rent-A-Tank. Maybe we'll be able to prevent an asteroid from crashing into the Earth and wiping out all life on our planet. But, and read the last sentence with me, it won't be easy. Hey guys, guess what? We did it. We read the whole book. I think we all deserve a round of applause. What do you say? Okay, great job, everyone. Hey, next week's book, if you want to read it along with me, will be Miss Daisy is still crazy. We're going to read this on start this on Monday. But before we go, how about our joke of the day? Okay, our joke of the day today comes from Logan from Orlando, Florida. Okay, and Logan says, "What do you get when you cross a dinosaur and a pig?" What do you get when you cross a dinosaur and a pig? Give up? Jurassic pork. Get it? Okay. All right. You can blame that one on Logan in Orlando, Florida. All right. It's time for you guys to get off the couch, stop staring at screens, and you know, Josh Salzman and Ryan Cunningham give us something wonderful. Let's do it.
My weird school. I'm aging and my school's a mess. My weird school. Before a school, it's fine, I guess. My weird school, where art is cool and the teachers are strange as a rule.
See you guys on Monday. Have a great weekend.